stranger.
Yes, that's what I feel like. Mrs. Mortimer wanted to see me.
Yeah, she just popped upstairs. She'll be a minute.
Oh. Oh, well, in that case, I'll take the weight off my feet. What's it about, do you know?
Yes.
Oh. Good news or bad?
Let's just say things are a little tense at the moment.
Are they ever anything else in this place?
She hasn't been able to find a replacement for Shuey McPhee.
So?
Well, the general idea seems to be to try and patch things up between you and him.
You what? You mean have him back in that kitchen?
Well, there doesn't seem to be any alternative, and there are other troubles too, Di.
Yes, well, I'm sorry, that's not my problem, but I am not having him back in that kitchen, and you can tell her that from me.
Now, look, sit down.
I'm sorry, but nobody seems to know what everybody's supposed to do in this place.
Now, look, why not ring David Hunter?
Have you got his number? Right.
If you take my advice, though, you'll listen to what Mrs. Mortimer's got to say first.
Oh, what's the point?
Well, okay, but don't bring David Hunter in a temper.
No, you're right. I want to know exactly what I'm going to say. Tom. It's Diane. Yes. Actually, I'm ringing you for some advice. Am I or am I not responsible for making decisions in your absence? Oh. Oh, well, that makes quite a difference, doesn't it? Oh, yes, I am. Okay, well, thank you. Bye-bye. Well, that settles that. He's coming back tomorrow. Okay, I'll see you later.
Got to stop meeting like this, eh?
Well, I'm sure that can be arranged. What are you doing here?
I came back to give in my lock a key.
Oh, really? Have you cleaned it out?
The locker.
The locker?
Aye.
Well, I'm sure Miranda will take your key.
Well, you haven't got anybody to take my place yet.
No, Shuey, you're irreplaceable. Thank God.
Pollard.
Mr. McPhee, what can I do for you?
Well, I forgot to hand in my locker key.
Thank you. It all seems so final, doesn't it?
Aye. End of an era, you might say. But that's the way Mrs. Diane Hunter wanted it. And as we know, her word is law.
I don't think that's the way she wanted it at all.
I think she was trying to get rid of me all along. She couldn't play her hand, though. Had to get the hang of the management. But all four wee cylinders were going in our mind. There it is.
Wouldn't you rather stay?
Aye.
Then why not do something about it?
I did. I handed in my resignation, and it was accepted.
What do you expect?
Well, I expected her to know where to draw the line, but she didn't.
Could be put right.
Are they thinking about it?
I don't want to break any confidences.
No, of course not, no.
But from what I do know, I think an expression of regret might not come amiss.
An apology, you mean?
Yes.
Ah, well, if that's the price, she can push a cold trolley straight to hell.
But I don't see how she could refuse a genuine...
A genuine grovelling?
Something along that line, yes. I'm sure she'd succumb to your charm if you handled it right.
There's nothing to be gained, and there's my pride to lose.
And there is your job. Unless you think if you wait in the wings long enough, she'll be overruled by Mrs. Mortimer. But Diane does have David Hunter's voting shares, and by tomorrow she'll have David Hunter. I don't think that's confidential. Everybody will know soon enough.
Well.
Good news?
Well, he's he's been away. He's no to know that she's been corrupted by power. She has overplayed her hand.
But remember, it's his hand she's playing. Maybe you're right. Maybe he'll undo what she's done. But it is a bit of a gamble, isn't it? And I think everybody might benefit if it's all sorted out by the time he gets back.
There's a lot in what you say, Miss Pollard. And thanks a lot. And it would be a favour to Mrs. Mortimer.
She'd be most grateful.
I think Mrs. Mortimer liked it very much.
Well, it couldn't be helped.
It could, Glenn. You've had plenty of notice.
Mum, I'm going. Isn't that enough? If Mrs. Mortimer doesn't like it, she can lump it.
Glenn.
Well.
I mean, she understood. I'm not saying she didn't, but I think she was in a bit of a mood.
That's nothing new.
Well, she and Mr. Chance hadn't been seeing eye to eye about something, you know.
I don't know about this blouse.
Looks lovely.
The collar's not sitting right.
Rubbish.
But it's too late to change now.
Well, it's easy to slip out of, you see.
Oh, I'm dreading this.
Don't be silly.
I really am, Mum.
But why?
I don't know.
Well, there you are, then. If you haven't got a reason, it's just rubbish, isn't it?
Suppose.
It's a check-up. It's just routine, that's all it is.
I've just got a feeling about
it. You know, you get yourself in such a state, don't you? That's half your trouble.
You didn't tell her what it was about, did you?
What?
Mrs. Mortimer.
Oh, no, nothing like that. No, I just said they wanted to see you, that was all.
I wouldn't want it all around the motel.
Oh, Mrs. Mortimer wouldn't dream of it.
No. Will it take long then, do you think, the check-up?
No, but you'll have a lot of hanging about to do, I expect, before you see them. There always is.
But the last time, you know.
Hey.
If they want me back, I'm not going.
Now, Glenn.
If it hadn't been for you and Dad, I wouldn't have...
You and Kevin. And more especially you, Glenda. It's really you. Now, it's got to be sorted out, so don't have any talk about not going again. There's enough. I mean, you probably won't have to go again, so there's no need to make a fuss, is there?
We're running a bit late, love. Will I do?
Oh, yeah.
Right, better after that, then.
Yes, I got your card.
Yeah.
Oh. That's for me.
Well, we better go. We'll be late. Bye, Mum.
Bye. Yes. A telegram? Oh, I see. Home next week, Ron. Oh, that's marvellous. Thanks. Yes, thanks ever so much. Bye. To Mr. Brownlow, please. Mrs. Brownlow. Arthur, you'll never guess what's happened.
Do you know what time Mr. Hunt is arriving tomorrow?
No. I just hope he's going to back me up, that's all.
Yes, I hope so too.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing.
You don't think Mrs. Mortimer will make him change his mind and let Shuey back in that kitchen, do you?
Look, I just want to get all this lot cleared up and get my suitcases packed.
Oh, are you going away?
Up to Scotland.
See your dad?
Why don't we go to the bar? I'll buy you a drink.
All right. Because I might not be here when you come back. Because if they let Shuey in that kitchen, I'll have had enough. Anyway, I'll see you in the bar about 6 o'clock. I'd better go and get changed, hadn't I?
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Mum's not about. She's popped out, I expect.
Why me?
Oh, listen.
What have I ever done?
It'll be all right, love. I mean, we'll be all right, honest.
I had a feeling about this. But nobody'd listen. I was just being stupid, wasn't I? So you all went on and on at me, and I had to go and give in.
Best to know.
Like hell it is. I didn't want to be told that, not ever.
Listen,
I could have hoped. Take that away and what's left?
Enough.
What?
Us. Us two. We've got each other, that's enough. Bill B. Glenn. This doesn't change anything between me and you.
It's all right, say that. No, it's spoiled everything.
No.
It's bound to. I wish I hadn't gone.
Oh, you're back then. Hey, you'll never guess what that phone call was about. Whatever's happened?
Nothing.
Oh, Glenn, look at you.
Nothing's happened at all.
Best say.
It wasn't worth the bother. I might as well have stayed here.
Glenn, please.
You better leave her.
What's going on? What did they tell her?
She can't have children.
Thank you very much. Just put it on my bill, please.
Excuse me. No. Julie, will you tell the girls in the kitchen I'll be in a minute?
Yes, they are.
Good evening. Look, I don't want to intrude, but if you've got a couple of minutes, maybe you'd like to sit down for a wee chat.
Thanks. I'll have a gin and tonic, please.
Eh?
Oh, Julie.
Yes?
Could I have a gin and tonic, please? Well?
Well, I was...
Yes?
I was wondering if we couldn't let bygones be bygones.
Were you?
Diane, are you not going to try and meet me halfway?
Are you trying to apologise to me?
Eh?
Well, you asked me to sit down and here I am, so go ahead.
Well, Mrs. Mortimer asked me personally if I would try to set things right.
Well, you're not making a very good job of it, are you?
Look, I am trying.
Oh, I couldn't agree more. Oh, thank you. Thanks very much.
Right.
Yes. Oh, Julie, will you put it on Mr. McPhee's bill, please?
Yes.
Cheers.
Are you trying to patronise me?
Me? I wouldn't dream of it.
Hello. Sorry I'm late.
Oh, hi.
Good evening, Mr. McPhee.
Good evening.
Should we go into the other bar?
Why not?
Look, why don't you spit the pride out of your mouth and get down to brass tacks?
Goodbye, Shuey. Good luck.
Sir? But what did they say?
Not a lot. Wasn't much to say. Sort of final.
Oh, Lord.
He was very nice, the bloke. Sympathetic. Funny thing is, I thought she was taking it all right. Sat there looking at him, sort of nodding. Quiet. You wouldn't expect her to say much, would you? But dead sensible. I was thanking the lucky stars for that. And about halfway home in the van, she started shaking.
Oh, poor love.
Really violently.
I suppose it was the shock.
Oh, scared the life out of me. I pulled off the road, put my arms around her, tried to say the right thing, whatever that might be. I could feel her shaking inside. Not crying, not a sound. Oh, scared stiff. Then she settled a bit, so I got her back.
Oh, why was I out when you came back?
Put the kettle on for a cup, I mean. She stood there, looking out the window for ages. Had a bit of a cry then, it helped a bit. Seeing you, it started her off again. What are we going to do?
I don't know. I'm blowed if I do.
What was that you were saying about the phone call?
Eh?
Didn't you come in?
All that, oh yes. Ron's coming home.
Great.
Yeah, next week.
Take it easy.
Oh, come and sit down, love, by me.
Yeah, I'm all right.
You haven't drunk your tea.
I don't want it.
Supper won't be long.
I'll go put the van in, I think. Yeah, I'll do that.
You know, then, it's great news, isn't it? I wouldn't have minded anything but that. It never even crossed my mind, you know? I thought good of all sorts of other things, but not that. Poor Ken.
Oh, he's all right. Yes, he is, love. He was just saying that.
Mom, he'd say anything to make me feel better. He's like that. We never even talked about a family. Not once. I thought it was some time way off. Now it's forever.
I hope you have a pleasant stay.
Thank you. Do you know, I've had this proxy business right up to here. I thought when they first explained it to me, it'd be a doddle.
Are you glad Miss Downs is coming back?
The 7th Cavalry in the nick of time. You bet I'm glad he's coming back. I was ready to pack it in, you know, and that includes Mrs. Mortimer.
You were a little mouse in a rat race, Di.
Well, he could have put it better, were you right?
It'll be interesting to see how Mr. Hunter solves the Shuey McPhee situation.
Well, he'll stay sacked.
He resigned.
All right, he resigned then, or else I'm off. I don't know why he still hangs around.
Mr. McPhee is not only a survivor, he's a no-fool survivor.
Well, it won't fool Mr. Hunter.
Not unless he lets him.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's too deep for me.
I learned a lot from Daddy. He's the smartest operator I know. Look, just keep your fingers crossed. Don't walk under any ladders and don't look at the new moon through a window. It won't do you any good, but at least you'll know you've tried everything.
Thank you, that's really uplifting.
Seriously though, Di, I hope it all works out.
Ta. Have a nice holiday.
I will.
I wish I was coming with you.
You'd be guessing at it, Glenn.
I'm not.
You are. It's what you think I ought to feel, but I don't.
What do you feel then?
I don't really know. But I don't feel let down.
You will.
But you are, you see, you're guessing.
There'll come a time.
Have we ever said anything about children?
Don't.
Well, have we ever?
No.
Given a choice, I don't know that I would. It's not the way things are. Generally, I mean. It's not much of a world, is it? I'm not just saying it, Glenn. I really mean it. If you think seriously about
it. Kevin, you just said the one word that matters.
What?
Choice. We don't have one.
Well, this is a turn-up, isn't it?
What?
With the Wanderer returns.
What are you on about?
Oh, Ron coming home.
Arthur, listen.
But Ron is...
Yeah, it's a telephone call's about her.
Bold you are, Ron, see that? Your long-lost brother's coming home. Give us a little smile.
Arthur, listen.
Were you keeping it as a surprise or something? Have I ruined it?
She's been to the hospital.
And?
I won't be turning you into a grandfather.
Well, I didn't know that's what it was
not
all about.
Ever.
Ever? Well, that's a shame, of course, but... Well, it's not the end of the world now, is it?
Oh, that's what I keep saying.
Other things in life, lots of other things. To tell you the truth, kids can be a bit of a tie, you know. I mean, after school, I mean, travelling's out once they start school.
True, I mean, look at Mum and Dad. 3 kids at school, that was a writer for years.
Yes, I mean, they keep you poor family,
you know. I can't play this game. I'm sorry, I just can't.
Game? What are you on about, Pet?
Pretending it doesn't matter.
Oh, now look, nobody...
It matters, all right? One hell of a lot. Her world's fallen apart. That's how much it matters.